Hello guys and welcome. Today you will learn how to create a 3D skybox and how to handle visGroups. So I made a simple map here, nothing fancy. And the first thing you're gonna want to do when creating a 3D skybox is to create a sky camera entity and place it right in the center of the map. And you can find that by following these bluish lines here. So just zoom in there and put it right in the middle. The sky camera entity we're creating here will be used as a reference point for the game, so it can know how to render the 3D skybox. You can see the 3D skybox scale there is 16 by default. So now I'm just going to select all the walls here and copy them over. We're going to use them as a reference when creating our 3D skybox. So I hold shift and left click drag to copy it there. And then I remove the old skybox entity there. I select all the things I'm going to use as reference. I turn on the texture lock so that the textures will scale also. I go to tools, transform, I set the mode to scale. And then I enter the value 0.0625 in all the fields because that will make it 1/16th of its current size. So there we have our little reference guide. Now I'm going to put all this into a visGroup so we can hide it and show it as we want to, because we don't want this to be rendered in the 3D skybox. So I select all the walls, I press Alt Enter to get this up. You can see that it's in the world geometry visGroup there right now. So I go to Edit Groups, I create a new group, and I'm going to call this one Skybox Reference. And then I close that, and I check the Skybox Reference checkbox that appeared there. This will make all this geometry go into the Skybox Reference visGroup we created. So now if you go to the User tab there under visGroups, you can uncheck the checkbox to hide that. And it won't get compiled if it's hidden, so that's exactly what we want. Now I'm going to create the geometry we want to have in the 3D skybox. So I zoom in here and just create a box. Maybe we could imagine it's a building or something. I create that there. And then I'm going to change the texture size to 0.02. That won't be entirely exact, but it's close enough to how it should be. So, now I'm going to create a skybox for the 3D skybox. It's exactly the same thing as creating a normal skybox. Just take the skybox texture there and create a box around this whole thing. And then I press Ctrl H to hollow that, and I have -16 as the value. I hide that skybox reference there, and here is our 3D skybox. So, now we're going to compile this and see how everything looks. And there you have it. So, that's about it. You can rate, comment, subscribe, and send me tutorial requests if you have any of those. Bye.